A woman can choose how she wants to be. So now we have very few women in the physique division, which demands the greatest amount of musculature. You know, you don't need a very high muscle mass and, you know, high level of conditioning with the, you know, great hypertrophy. That is because, you know, even the Federation wants that the competition should not be too freaky. So, you know, and secondly, when you have, you know, more natural kind of structure on the stage, it becomes very inclusive. So now bodybuilding and fitness is coming closer to how it should be ideally, you know. So there's a lot of emphasis on presentation. Like I'm now judging the show. So we give a lot of emphasis on the presentation also. And, you know, how you dress yourself, how you tan yourself, everything is important. Because if we would have just kept it to pure bodybuilding, it would never have grown that large. The second thing is that we want that when girls, you know, understand how diet and exercise affects their bodies and their abilities, they will carry that, you know, the sportswomen have a very short shelf life. So what they do after retirement, whether they retire at 30 or 50, what they carry back to their home and for their children and the habits that they form, which will help them to live a good quality of life, you know, for the rest of their lifetime. That is very important. So just to make it all inclusive, they are having all these divisions. So I feel when it comes to body shaming, you know, if there is a woman who is not competing, she may not be, you know, as perfect, you know, have that perfect extreme leanness or hourglass figure or whatever. You know, you in a bodybuilding show, you are choosing the structure of your choice and making yourself that.